So I have to start by asking you about what's happening behind us. Who are these photos of?
Some of these photos are mine, and this is me and my kids, and my step-parents, and the rest of the pictures are my family's crew. It's a mix of my and their family.
So now that we started the conversation with the photo being of you, and it's filmed with Leia, very close to you too. It's based on your own experience. What was the process like translating a trip that you took with your husband to the screen?
At the beginning, the writing was very autobiographical, and then I had to take freedom with this, and I put fiction on that, and I create a movie character because it was the idea. So some details were really important for me to keep the truth, like the places where they are going, it's the exact same places where I've been with my husband. It was really important for me. The lady, when they're in the cemetery in Krakow, the lady who speak to the kids, she's a real survivor. It was important for me that it couldn't be an actress. It was really important for me. So a few details like that had to be real.
And when you went on the trip initially, did you know you were going to make a film out of it, or were you thinking this was?
No, not at all. We did that trip, and I wrote some stuff, but I had no clue. I didn't know if it, maybe it could be a novel, or maybe nothing, or maybe. And then a few years after that, it was really important for me. It has to be my first movie. It was really strong.
It's interesting because you go through the character, I'm assuming this was similar to your experience, where you go into the film and you have this real hope, it seems, that this is going to be a really fun, almost, experience. It's called My Poor Honeymoon, that it'll be that you have the potential of making it this very romantic trip, and you see this change in emotion. I wonder what it was like for you to then go back to shoot this film in Poland and revisit that after it was such a sort of tumultuous emotional journey for you.
It was also very emotional, but in another miracle. And I met so many great people there, and we were very, very happy making that movie. So yeah, when I it was also very joyful memories.
I'd love to open it to questions from the audience. Right here.
I'll repeat that. Sorry, I probably didn't follow the film. So your grandmother was born in Poland and eventually moved to France.
Yeah.
So she was a survivor.
No, for real, because that's where I...
So the question just for the people in the back was about your grandmother's story. Was she was born in Poland?
Yeah, she was born in Poland, and then she moved to France when she was a kid, and she was even in France during the war. So it's not the exact same history. Anna has not the exact same history of me, because I missed my both grandmother's stories. Because on my dad's side, I had another history. She's from Romania, and so I missed, the two histories, more or less.
Did your mother really show up on your trip?
No. You know what, my mom, she's even worse than the character. She wouldn't have been able to come to Poland, and she kept doing all the shooting. She was calling me literally every day to tell me, you have to come back, you can't be there. I'm not happy knowing you're in Poland, you have to go back to France. And I was like, mom, I'm doing my first movie, that's something you should be happy for me. No, I can't be happy knowing you're in Poland, it's impossible. No, it's a disease at that point.
Are you still married to Adam?
Yes. And the baby from the movie is 10-year-old now, so.
how was it directing someone who looked just like you telling your story?
So what was the casting like for you? What was the directing?
Norma, I did not know. I know she, apparently, she does, because a lot of, you're not the only one to tell me that, but to be honest, when you look at her in real life, we don't look like each other. I think has an acting process, she might, you know, took some stuff from me, you know, but so that was not the idea, no. I knew her not personally, but I knew her as an actress, and I was crazy about her. I was sure she would be the perfect person to be, because I needed an actress at the same time very funny and very intense and able to play some very, very tough emotion. And she said, yes, sorry, I was very happy.
Do you see it now? Do you see
yes,
it?
Yes, I'm still very happy.
My parents, did your grandmother's family come with her to France, or were they?
My mom was born in France, in Paris, and my grandmother, she came before the war, escaping the pogroms, and it was an early immigration before the war.
Has your husband stayed in touch with any of the people he met in the town that he went back for?
No, we didn't, but when I was preparing the movie, some of them gave us some clue, because one day we saw an event that, I don't know how, but some people, they learned that I was doing the movie, and so they were chatting about that, oh, RV, there's a movie in Greenland about the trip, and so now I told us, of course, and the lady that you can see, the lady who plays the mom of the lady who's speaking in the village, she's the real lady who invited us for the real commemoration.
Okay. Have you shown it in Poland and they are
not yet, but in 2 weeks the movie will be in the festival in Warsaw, so I'm really excited to see how they're going to react. But I think French and Polish are, you know, everyone, I'm not making fun just of them, you know, I'm making fun of everyone in the movie, so I hope they will do that.
The film was beautifully made. I was surprised to hear it was your first movie. How did you acquire the skill to pull this off?
It's incredible that this is your first film, just to repeat for the back. And where did you learn how to make a film?
My first job is to be an actress, so I spent a lot of time on sets. So I learned looking at other directors doing their job.
What are you making next? You should maybe make a movie about Chopin. It's okay, it was.
I like his music.
Or about Hamlet,
yeah. What else? I'm writing about family again. It could be another story, but it's still about family and relationship.
Time for just two more questions, yeah?
The movie takes place in Krakow, which is just a few hours' drive from Auschwitz, and yet Auschwitz does not appear in the movie. Were you debating on that?
How did you decide not to include Auschwitz?
When we did the trip for real with my husband, we went to Auschwitz, of course. And when I was writing the movie, at the beginning there was a scene, and quickly I felt that I didn't want to have some fiction in this place. I was very uncomfortable to shoot a non-fiction story there. So I didn't want to, and that's why I decided to write that they were not going there. I didn't want to shoot a fictional movie there. It was difficult.
Thank you very much, it's really beautiful. wondering if there's any place that it could be watched after the. Is it available?
So the question is about, it's a beautiful movie, and where can people see the movie? And I'm going to answer first that you can tell your friends to come see it on Tuesday at the Filatura Theater. But where else can it be seen?
Right now, here in America, it's going to be in a few festivals. And then it will be released, hopefully, I don't know yet exactly where, because the American distributor decide his strategy right now. And so I don't know yet, but hopefully here, I don't know.
And was it part of the way that the distributors decide where the film's open is how well they do at festivals like ours? So tell your friends and you know, make it known that you want to see it here.
Is there really a...
Yeah, can you talk about the section in Krakow?
Yeah, it's, I didn't show up, you know, in the movies, exactly like you can see in the movies, yeah.
Can you talk a little bit, because we were talking about how it changed in the time since you first went there and joined?
Yeah, it was even more when I came back to shoot the movie a few years after. So now it's big, you know, you have restaurants and little cars. It's literally like Adam, it's a Disneyland, you know, it's really strange. So you have a strange feeling back there because it's back and forth. In a way, you're happy because it's a way to keep the memory alive, you know? And in the other way, it's so fake and so commercial and so... So, it's strange.
I really like the way you go from that square where they're selling these things to the cemetery and this stark difference between the presentation of Jewish life and what Jewish life actually felt like to you when you were there.
Yes. That this imagery is a very precious place because it's you have stones from very, very old stones. It's a miracle, but it's very not destroyed by bones, so it's amazing. And yes, it was really important for me to. You have the feeling there that you have the real, you're in touch a little with the lost world for real in that place, not in the square with all the fake restaurants. Last question.
Yeah, I'm very struck by the tension between the desire to remember and the desire to forget. Mm-hmm. And I'm wondering whether, you know, you see this generational and almost anticipate where is the next step? Where is your son?
So that's interesting. Like the question, and we've talked a little, and you see in the film the three generations and the difference in the way the grandmother might have dealt with her past and then her daughter and then the character who's based on you. And you can talk a little bit about that, but also where do you think the next generation is going to be with this history?
It was really important for me to make the movie while survivors are still here, you know. My grandmother sadly is not here anymore, but you know, I don't know why I had that feeling, it needed to be done before. So, I don't know, I think we took the liberty to, you know, to have a different approach with the subject because we were able, our parents were, it was impossible for them, you know, to question and to ask and you know, so we took that liberty, and right now I think we need to keep the memory alive very strongly because we're in a dangerous time, and you know, because the survivors are very old right now, we need to be strong and active and hope that the next generation will continue to speak about that tragedy, you know. So I try to be positive, and I think we might have a new way of thinking, you know. After the testimony time, we will have another, you know, way to think, to have reflection about this history. I hope so. But we need to be careful and to be, yeah, very, very careful and yeah.
Well, thank you so much for sharing this. Thank you all for being here.